Mike Van, I shouldn't be doing your presentation, but the notion came up yesterday or the day before that maybe there'd be time, and I said no, and he said, well, but maybe somebody won't show up, and I said, well, it doesn't matter, because I'll take too long. But I was thinking about it, and I thought if it seemed okay, then maybe I would, because I won't take too much time, and I promise I won't bore you like I usually would. But there's a text that is very important to me that I don't need to show because it's kind of brief and it's in my head anyway. It was very important to me when I was studying for comprehensives when I was finishing up my PhD over 12 years ago now. So a couple years before that, I was doing all of these readings of strange texts. My PhD was in Italian literature. So for my degree, we had to read everything. 900 years worth of literature, and a lot in each century. And so in reading all of the old stuff, I encountered a lot of devotional texts and, you know, the famous poem by St. Francis that everybody has to read because it has actually a cruciform structure within it. Really cool stuff, but also, you know, of a certain sort. And then I came across this one text by a poet who would, many years later, give the name to my pet turtle. So the reason I want to share this text with you is that a lot of people ask me, why is your turtle named Cecco? And why, in fact, is he named Cecco Angiolieri? Well, he's named Cecco Angiolieri because this text, it dates back to about 1260. It's a sonnet. It's amazing, and it blew my mind when I read it. It's written in a very refined, conditional and subjunctive structure that's called the periodo ipotetico. It's really old, it's totally crazy, and it's not necessarily extremely well known. Cecco was kind of contemporary of Dante. They were friends until they had a political fallout and then they hated each other. Then they wrote sonnets about each other, talking shit about each other. This is a 13th century rat battle in sonnet form. And one of the most famous insults is Cecco calling Dante an ox. Like his rhymes weren't good or something. I'm a big fan of Dante, but then I became a big fan of Cecco. Cecco is my turtle name. So I'm going to share the text with you, and then I'll share it in translation. And then I think you'll see why I wanted to share it today, because it's very relevant to everything from Piss Christ to Pinochotto and Chiavola. And I think it's also very relevant to our current political climate, and probably also global warming. So I'm going to recite it first in Italian, and it's in a really old Tuscan, somewhat dialectical Italian. It's impossible to recite it without shouting a little bit, so I'm going to shout a little bit, which will help me not bore you. And then I'll translate it, probably not shouting. So, it's called If I Were Fire, and the real title is Se Fossi Fuoco. Se io fossi fuoco, arderei il mondo. E se io fossi vento, tempesterei. Se io fossi acqua, la negherei. E se io fossi Dio, manderei in profondo. Se io fossi Papa, sarei allora giocondo che tutti i cristiani imbrigherei. E se io fossi imperatore, sa che farei? A tutti mozzerei il capo a tondo. Se io fossi morte, andrei da mio padre, e se io fossi vita, andrei da lui, similmente farei da mia madre. E se io fossi cieco, come sono e fui, torrei le donne giovani e leggiadre, e vecchie vaide rasserei altrui. So that's the original version. The translation would be basically, if I were fire, I would torch the world. And if I were the wind, I'd storm it. If I were water, I'd drown it in flood. And if I were God, I'd send it straight to hell. If I were the Pope, then I'd be quite happy. Because I'd swindle all the Christians. And if I were the Emperor, you know what I'd do? I'd chop off everyone's head. If I were Death, I'd pay my father a visit. And if I were Life, I'd leave him. I'd do pretty much the same to my mother. And if I were Checo, as I am and was, I'd snatch up all the pretty little girls and leave the ugly old ones to everyone else. You see how relevant it is, especially in the time. It's the whole thing. The whole thing. But also, it's written in this wonderful, refined meter and rhyme, and in this periodo ipotetico, and it has very strange language things going on in it. And it's kind of a beautiful sonnet anyway. I mean, I didn't make it sound beautiful, but it kind of sounds beautiful. And it's just full of all this rage and kind of joy also. And then there's this thing, and languages are kind of my thing, and a little turn of words can interest me forever. And there's this line at the end where he says, if I were Checo, as I am and was. And in fact it says, come sono e fui. And that in Italian means, as I am and as I was a long time ago. It's not fui was, it's fui like was 500 years ago. It's called the passato remoto. It means like way long ago. That makes no sense to say as I am and was in that remote past. So it's like this duplicitous thing, and it's almost like also putting himself in the present and into a really deep history. And that's kind of what art does, too. And maybe what exchange rates does. So anyway, thanks all of you for coming. Thanks to all my exchange rates collaborators. Thanks to Buggy Factory. Thanks to Enrico. Thanks to all the speakers today. They were all great. And of course, if it weren't for visitors, then we'd be here shouting in rooms at ourselves. We'd probably be shouting at each other. But anyway, thank you very much.